Good morning, here from Mandalay in Burma. Now, let me just fill you in on what I know so far, which is absolutely nothing about Burma, really. I have four main places I want to hit up: Mandalay, Bagan, Lake Inlay, and Yangon. So mainly I'm going to be taking you on a bit of a sightseeing, kind of touristy tour of Mandalay. They drive on the British side of the car and on the French side of the road. Explain that, I can't. Yeah, let's hit up some historical monuments and I'll try and teach you as much as I teach myself, and let's get on with it. I was literally just about to talk to the camera and then electronic Big Ben just went off. That is so strange. Is it 11? No, it's 10 o'clock. That was the correct time. Okay, so that pagoda there was pretty cool. You can tell it's pretty important to Burmese culture still, because there were hundreds of people queuing up to worship in front of the Buddha's face, so that was kind of cool. So yeah, that temple spot I was just in there, like kind of tucked in among a huge market. Kind of a local hideout too, lots and lots and lots of people there just buying, selling, chilling out, worshipping. It was a cool spot, but I've seen more than enough of it now. I'm gonna go head uptown and see what else is there. What's going on in there is they're sculpting new Buddha statues. It's also very loud. There's almost nothing creepier in this world than escalators turned on. That is not natural. Like abandoned and empty up here. You can just hear all the ambient sounds of the market behind you. So if you're wondering where I actually am, it's the Zaycho market in Mandalay. This has been the highlight of today so far. The temples, it was cool, but wasn't anything I haven't seen before. Yeah, to find like a cool abandoned building or semi-abandoned building outside of a marketplace that's just bustling is really cool. Plus, I really like 60s kind of communist-y architecture, and this place kind of gives that vibe. 50,000 people used to live here. Now it's a ghost town.
Our so-called leaders prostituted us to the West, destroyed our culture, our economies, our honor.
The bathrooms aren't in too bad of a way though. Let's see if we can get through the door. Dun 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 dun. Denied. Power to the building. Not locked up. Maybe I should close that. Okay, I think it's time to bounce. Just saw a security guard. Whoops. This building here, the Zaycho Market, is actually really, really interesting. It's basically just like a skid row block of just desolate poverty and like a really communist-y style building from probably like the 50s or the 60s. But now they've just turned it into a huge marketplace. It has that kind of grimy look, but you know, it's full of happy people selling their goods. So, you know, What a good find. And that over there is the semi-abandoned building I was just playing around in. Now it's a ghost town. I'll give you another reason why I'm really, really enjoying this HO market. Despite it being the largest market in Mandalay, it has such a bad rep on places like TripAdvisor. I'm basically the only white person walking around this building actually looking at this market that I've seen. Now, one thing I will address while I'm up here actually is people always say like, oh, you're going to Myanmar, you're going to Burma? Man, you're gonna have such a good time. There's like no tourists, it's gonna be great. Yeah, newsflash, tourists everywhere. The borders opened in what, like 2011, 2012, when Wasserface, yeah, when she became whatever she is now, like, they opened the borders and people have been roaming around since. There's loads of establishment here. Is it the same as Thailand, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia? Not even close. Nowhere near as touristic, but if you're asking me, is there lots of tourism? I'm gonna say, yes, yes, there is. What have we here? This is so freaking weird. It's like someone had a wedding party and a band and a big event and a promotion or something in 1991, and the place hasn't seen life since. One of the weirdest discoveries I've probably had traveling, just because I didn't expect it at all. Good call. Don't think that's gonna budge. The urbex has to finish there, sadly. I think it's back to the streets for me. If any of you actually are interested in urbexing or exploring weird, cool places in Asia, there's a really cool place called Ho Thai Tien in Hue in Vietnam. It's worth checking out. They've got a dragon and shit. All I've ordered was a chicken curry and a drink. And look how much food they've served me. So I could barely finish that massive feast. I barely touched it, to be honest. There was that much food, and then they brought me complimentary dessert. Okay, so that's absolutely massive meal that I was just served. I paid 8,000 chat for it. That is about £4.81. What? So yeah, if you find yourself in downtown Mandalay and you're looking for an absolute feast of amazing Burmese food, Minglamar Restaurant, hit it up. Incidentally, that's how you say hello in Burmese. Minglamar, learning new things every day. So after like an hour and a half of recouping back at the hostel after an entire morning of did about 9 miles this morning walking around the city, and I did take transport in the end, so it just goes to show you how big this city is, and I didn't even go to its outer reaches. Heading now to the Grand Palace, but I have to walk the long way around because there's a foreigner entrance and a local entrance. Standard. So the ticket cost 10,000 cha, which is like maybe £5, £6, so not too expensive, not a problem. And it also gives me access to a bunch of other places I want to see later today and tomorrow. So we'll see if this long old walk is worth it. Not a bad little vantage point up here. I know there's cannons. So, have we found out anything inherently interesting in the Grand Palace? Not a lot. When King Mingden, the last king of Burma, when he was ruling the place, he subjugated to the British like that, and then went to exile in India. All of this stuff you can see was bombed to shit by the British as a lashback against the Japanese invading in 1944 or 45, I think. And that's about it, really. Didn't really learn much, but pretty cool seeing the architecture rebuilt.
So it was cool to kind of like check out what was, but let's go see some real history that isn't mimicked or rebuilt, and we'll do that now.
Well, I was absolutely beat after that Grand Palace. It's so far and so big, and I accidentally got talking to a motorcycle taxi guy, which is my favorite way to travel anywhere in a city in Asia, to be fair. He was really nice, and he was like, yeah, I'll do you a cheap deal. You can go and see this pagoda and this pagoda that are free, and then I'll take you up to Mandalay Hill for the sunset. So I'm checking out this one, which I'll put the title of what this place is called down below, but he literally just dropped me off. I've got no idea where I am. But if you hadn't noticed, it's got hundreds of white cheddies or stupas, whatever you want to call them, everywhere. Yeah, all of those writings, I guess, are like ancient Buddhist / Burmese history, things like that. Yeah, every single one of these has a huge like tablet slab of it in there, which is pretty cool. That's kind of like a scaled down version of where we are. This place is huge. Look at all of that. So this place turned out to be an absolute find. So great shout. Right, now I'm gonna head back to him and see if he'll drive me up to Mandalay Hill in time for the sunset, because it's coming down pretty fast, so better get a move on. Okay, so we're up here on Mandalay Hill for the sunset, which happens over the next half an hour. But the building up here is absolutely stunning. Just got back after a very fun last ride with Aung Aung from the sunset up at Mandalay Hill. That was an intense full first day, damn. My mileage is like closing in on 12. Okay, so that day was long and intense, and like, I might have moaned a little bit about being tired or it being a long day, but can I just point something out? This is my step count, my mileage, and all that jazz. 11.6 miles, 28,000 steps, and 40 floors. Okay, so I'm out here outside the Ostello Bello in Mandalay. Great hostel, check it out. Yeah, I just rented a bicycle. I'm gonna go ride around the outskirts of town, see if I can get to the Ubain Bridge. So I've made it to the border road that runs all along the Irrawaddy River. I think I'm saying that right. So yeah, I've been riding for about 45 to an hour now. Probably got about an hour and a half left until I get to Inwa. Hopefully some of those cycling shots didn't look too shaky. I've got the new image stabilization going on the Hero 5 Black, so hopefully that looks better. And right, I'm gonna get back on the road. Hello. Yeah, there we go. Instant travel shots. I've just pulled over, I'm about halfway. I'm pretty tired already. I've done about 8 miles and I've got about 8 to go. It's actually further than the map said. Brilliant. Yeah, it's tiring, but that was a beautiful road. It's gonna continue to be beautiful, and I can't wait to get further out of the city.
Right, let's do it. Making their way downtown.
Okay, I made it about 1 minute, not even that, down the road, and look what I found. To be honest, any opportunity to get lost in nature is always one that I will take gladly. Okay, let's get actually back out on the road this time.
It's
goals. Bike ride necessitates a ferry to get over to India, so I'm just loading on the boat now. Right, let's get off this thing. So that boat cost about the equivalent of about 71p English. When people talk about Burma being expensive, I think it's accommodation only. So we just got off the boat and it's already rivaling Cambodia for people trying to sell you stuff. But that's what all that noise is. Okay, I didn't expect that. The amount of horse and carts here just standing around in the sun is disgusting. Equally, why you shouldn't ride elephants in Cambodia and places like that, or Thailand or anywhere else, standing around in the day with harnesses on their back, not being fed or watered. Look at all these horses. Sad, really. Okay, if any of you have ever been to Cambodia and you've been to Phnom Penh, you know that you can rack up somewhere between 50 to 80 offers of tuk-tuk drivers inside of about 2 hours. I've only been on this island where Inwa is for like 5 minutes and I've already been offered a horse and cart about 30 times, which tells me there's far too many horses and carts here and not enough business. So please release your horses. Do something else with your horse. Stop riding around Western tourists. Make them fucking walk. On the road again. I can't wait to get on the road again. Start walking through the Wild West. Okay, so I'm here at Inwa's East Gate behind me here. I've just been doing some reading on the City of Gems, as it was once called. It was the royal capital of Burma, or Myanmar, for like 400 years, with the odd exception here and there where capitals moved about depending on the wishes and sackings of different kings from different places. So yeah, after the sacking of Saigyang, which is nearby, which was the capital before this, this became the capital, like I said, for on and off for about 400 years, until eventually this place kind of fell and the royal seat moved over to, I believe, current day Mandalay, and then that was the last royal capital before the British sacked and invaded Burma and annexed it as British Burma. Yeah, a little bit of history for you there. If any of that was wrong, I apologize. Okay, so I'm just heading to the first temple slash monastery inside of the old walls of Inwa. So let's see if it was worth this very long trip. I know it's a fake tiger, but it does lead to a good point. Don't go supporting any tiger businesses while you're in Asia. They're almost always drugged, and if they're not drugged, they're declawed. It's cruel to the animal, it's totally unnecessary. It is not natural for you to be able to go and sit with a tiger and cuddle it. It would rip your face off, all right? And while we're on the topic of ethical tourism in Asia, don't ride elephants. How many more times? Don't ride elephants. Okay, so I just finished up there at the, I'm gonna attempt the name, Shwe Haketor, probably said that completely wrong, monastery in Inwa. To be honest, I saw it more as a playground than a monastery because there wasn't anyone there and everything was in ruins for the most part, but I'm gonna head down further into the walls of the old city and go see what the actual ruin of Inwa looks like. The gang of the world's most vicious animals. Oh, so cute. There is no actual Inwa monument, apparently, because the field that maps.me and Google pops it in, I've just traipsed through the whole thing and got whole cuts on my legs trying to find this kind of, like, historic thing in this field. There's nothing there. It's all farmland. On top of that, I found this big tower, and it's only from the 1800s, and that even got rebuilt because of an earthquake. So, really, I've come all this way for jack all so far, so, hopefully the other pagodas and stuff around this area redeem it, and that's what I've seen in photos, because so far this has just been a complete waste of time. And I'm very exhausted, I'm very thirsty, and I haven't eaten since 8 a.m. and it's now nearly 2, so, you know, hopefully the day turns around. my luck changed. I went from being tired and hungry and thirsty and miserable to all of those things except miserable, because I found the temple by complete chance that I was looking for inside of Inwar anyway. So it turns out this place is really, really beautiful, so I am sort of glad I came all this way, but I'm still starving and thirsty, so I'm going to go head out and see if I can grab some food around here. Run away! Run away! A man in a massive farming vehicle came along and saved the day and just saved me a mile's walk in this horrible heat by giving me a lift in his big tractor thing. So cheers, mate. Just gone 3 o'clock and I'm starving, but I'm looking forward to some decent Burmese curry. If you haven't tried it, Burmese curry is amazing. Also, I'd like to temporarily be an advocate for sunblock, because, or sunscreen or sun cream, whatever you call it, because this is not on. This is not okay. Now, I think it's a Burmese custom, because this is the second time it's happened now in like 24 hours, but I've ordered just chicken curry and rice and they've brought all of that. Amazing. And while we're here, let's go through those dishes, shall we? I'll start with the broth. It's got like a hint of tomato soup, sort of, but the flavours are just so much more than that, and there's so much in it too. Right, second dish, spicy potato. Good. Only a tiniest bit of spice, but really good potato. This stuff, though, looks like what I'd call it musato, but it kind of looks like salsa. I'm gonna try the tiniest bit. Ooh, that's interesting. Yeah, it's chili and spicy, but it's like more fishy, not like musato. And then we know what rice tastes like and chicken tastes like, so I don't need to go into that, but you should try, come to Burma, try the food, it's amazing. It's also a wonderful plate of greens here that I will attempt to touch. Yeah, I'm gonna dig in. This is just a place basically on the side of the river, well out of town, sort of in a tourist donation, but not donation? Location. But the food is incredible. Like, and that's just the broth. That's like a basic bitch dish that they have here. Like, that's not even like something nice off the menu, but it's amazing. So that lunch was absolutely delicious. I'm gonna try and make my way to the Ubin Bridge. I think I'm saying that right. It's the big teak bridge in Mandalay that's crazy famous. I'm just gonna kick it there for a couple hours once I get there, watch the sunset, and then I'm gonna ride on home and collapse. So I managed to find myself a blue temple. This is really cool. I completely didn't expect to see this. Look at this. The main temple complex is in there, and it looks like a school for monks. I won't be going in though, because all temples and monasteries close at 4:30 here, and it's just gone 4:36, so just missed my mark. But even the blue stuff outside is pretty cool. Is it blue stuff? Okay, it's cheddies and temple complexes, but still, it's blue stuff. Or is it more of a tealy green? It's turquoise. That's what colour it is. Okay, so I'm here on the Ubin Bridge, and for lighting purposes, I'm walking backwards right now. But basically, the whole bridge is just people taking selfies and lots and lots of locals commuting and getting in the way of people's photos. Bridge is not fully stable. lots of locals as well as tourists genuinely using it in their commute. It's an interesting wobbly teak bridge, longest teak bridge in the world apparently. And yeah, there's like a concrete bit in the middle of it that kind of really ruins what it looks like, but I guess it keeps it standing. But yeah, I'm just kind of in the crop fields below the bridge now, because actually most of the dry season, what it is at the moment, that's why it's so hot and why I'm scarlet. You can grow stuff here because the water level's so low, so there's actually sunflowers growing behind me. That's cool. Okay, so I've just finished up here on the Ubane Bridge and tried to get a couple of time lapses of the sunset, which was spectacular. So yeah, just gonna cycle back to the hostel and pass out. That's not a dress, that's an Audrey Hepburn movie. Finally made it back to the bicycle, now it's time for the ridiculously long ride home. I'll see you then. Okay, so I made it back after like another 10 mile ride on that bicycle, all the way to Ostello Bello, which is where I'm staying. Great hostel, great food, I just had a really good dinner. I'm gonna go shower all of this filth off of me and try and deal with all this sunburn. That's pretty much it, guys. I'm leaving for Lake Inlay tomorrow. That's pretty much it for the Mandalay vlog. If you've liked it, tell us what you liked, give us a thumbs up, subscribe, that would be great. If you didn't like it, tell me why in the comments. Okay, I'm gonna leave it there and I'll see you guys in Lake Inlay.